I'd like to do a project update for Dragonflow today. My name is Dima, I'm from Huawei Tel Aviv Research Center. Omer could not come, so he asked me to do it. So let's begin. What's Dragonflow? First of all, for anyone who's not familiar, it's a SDN controller for Neutron. We try our best to have an approach that is lightweight, distributed, and keep the code base really small. We do it with Open vSwitch and OpenFlow. We try to rely on any databases you might want by keeping it pluggable and distributed. That's about it, like one sentence about Dragonflow. We started in Cairo. We have about 20 contributors in the last release, mainly from Huawei and Fiberon. We are a small project. In Pike, we did quite a lot actually with our small hands. Small come out hands. We are trying to finish a lot of RVMs to have a support for Kubernetes and other containers more easily by having several networks in single port. And we also try to merge service function chaining. It's an implementation of the API defined by network in SFC, separate project. We will support MPLS for the first part. It's mainly done. And we will try to bring NSH in the next phase, I think, for Queens. We did a makeover of our existing network services like security groups and port security to support IPv6. And we added other services like neighbor discovery to support to add more support for IPv6 tenants. We started working on merging BGP, the dynamic routing, in our code base right now. It is also an implementation of a Neutron dynamic routing project. We added support for Cassandra database for our northbound backend. And we finished our Ansible deployment playbooks also in this release, so you can deploy with Ansible right now. The other thing that we did is port security, QoS, port QoS. We implemented the TCP marking and max bandwidth and max burst came with limitations with open vSwitch. We implemented distributed SNAP. It's a network model that allows you to go out of your compute node directly without going to the network node, just like in the start of the thinking of in DVR this cycle. It basically allows each compute node to be its own network node in the sense of being able to support that, support as that. We also did some major heavy lifting inside our code base to make the addition of new services much easier. We changed, like, I think 30% of our code to make the addition of new features be much localized. Just implement a driver, just implement the application in the end, and all the in-between part will be done for you. We have some nice specs about this. And the things that we want to do for Queens. Well, we always want to implement more network services, so we are looking to implement Airbus V2 and FUAS and any other network services that anyone would like to have. And if you have any suggestions, we are happy to hear. We are exploring currently to support not just Open vSwitch and OpenFlow, but other backends like iPod and eBPF, it's not something we have a very clear action item list how to proceed about it, but we think that we can benefit a lot from having other backends as well. We are looking into much closer integration to other projects, like a career about going through a neutron, and we think of integrating with other agent types. We think of integrating with other agent types like OpenVisage agent, so you can have both Dragonflow and OpenVisage agent deployed at the same environment in case you wanna try us out or do a rolling migration. One of the other things that we have a blueprint on it, we want to start working on is a VM level quality of service, which is the next step of the port level quality of service, which aggregates all the traffic of one VM, not just one port. And we're doing a bunch of stuff, but that's the main thing that we want to do from Waze. That's about my list. And we are always happy to hear what do you want to see in Dragonflow. What are you missing to deploy us? Whether it's packaging or features that we need we should have. We are also looking for more developers and contributors to help us review and design and implement all those blueprints. That's it for the project update. So if anyone has a question, grab a mic or... Yeah.
I will answer that. So so the question was, have we done some scalability testing for the Dragonflow? And the answer is we have. We've done a scalability on the control plane for our Dragonflow, as it is a control as the controller. We've done the benchmarking, we actually presented it in Barcelona. We had help from Strato AG, who were gracious to contribute 40 servers on their cloud. And we've actually did benchmark for 4,000 Dragonflow control nodes. The test was to try and run Dragonflow distribute the neutron, the updates for network creation, subnet creation, port creation, and deletion. We deployed first a single controller on each server, so we had about 36 of them. And we used Redis as the database with three shards. Each shard had their replication, so six Redis. And after getting this baseline, the performance was about three ports a second and one network a second. That we didn't try to optimize that, but was mainly a performance of a neutron in our setup, not Dragonflow. But we just wanted to see how that gets changed or varied when we go from 36 controllers to 4,000 controllers. And we were really surprised to learn that it just didn't affect at all the numbers. So we get the same exact performance for 4,000 points. So I think it's good.
Surprise.
Yeah, so we didn't try more than 4,000 because we ran out of hardware. But we will actually do that if we get more machines from someone else to test that with us.
Okay. Thank you.
Have you given any thought to a migration path from ML2 obvious to ML2 plus Dragonflow? I know Dragonflow acts as an ML2 mechanism driver, so it should be pretty easy to migrate between the two.
Well, we have this blueprint on allowing Dragonflow and other type of agents to work together. So we hope that you can deploy just, I don't know, 10% of your machines as Dragonflow, and then see how it goes and have this rolling upgrade working when the agents can interact with it. So.
Is that something that needs to be done with the whole of Neutron at Pike version, or can it be done with different versions? Like, let's say we're currently in the process of going to Mitaka, can I use the Pike version of Dragonflow with the Mitaka version of Neutron? Do you rely on anything specific in the Neutron code base, or is that just compatible enough between releases?
I think you might run into some trouble. Between versions, I haven't tested it myself. I don't think it's something.
But the compatibility should be there in Pike. The compatibility or this interoperability should be there in Pike.
I don't think it will be in Pike, but I hope it will be in Pike.